Okay, here we go. Good morning, everybody. It's good to be here, Selvan. Thank you very much for the invitation, and I'm really happy to share a bit of my experiences with you. Let's start. Rob van der Wijngaard. I'm the director of the Leiden University. And I'm responsible for the Financial Shared Service Center, HR Shared Service Center, IT, and also documents systems. And I'm also a project advisor at Cape Town a University, and I really enjoy that a lot. I spent a lot of months already in Cape Town. Visited Joburg, and to be honest, I fell a bit in love with South Africa. I'm also a speaker and trainer, and I'm part of the SAP Advisory Council. I would like to ask you to log in this software environment. You can do it by taking a photo of the QR code or www.sendsteps.me and log in with the code 335051. I will give you a few seconds to log in, please, because I would like to make it interactive. Yeah, does it work? Okay, let's start. First question for you. What elements do you think play a role in a radical digital transformation? Is it A, technology, B, technology and processes, C, technology, processes, organization, people and customer interaction, or D, none of them? I'm curious what your way of thinking is, and there is no good or no fault, of course. Just curious what your way of thinking is. Okay, let's have a look. Okay, that's really cool. So in your opinion, it's C, technology, processes, organization, people, and customer interaction. Okay, let's look further. The definition of a digital transformation is that digital transformation is as much as a cultural and business transformation as it is a technical one. So cultural, business, and technical. It's a fundamental rethinking of customer interaction, business models, and operations. And it's about finding new ways of deliver value, generate revenue, and improve efficiency. And that's interesting, because when you look at that definition, it's more or less a very complex puzzle with a variety of topics. And in my opinion, when you are dealing with a variety of topics, it is complex. It is important to apply structure. And I've been working with the Glovelief model. And the Glovelief model gives me structure. It gives an organization structure. And the Cloverleaf model contains the five most important pillars of an organization. The organization pillar, how is your organization structured? The IT pillar, of course. Processes, how are you organizing your processes? The people part, and the way how you're organizing your customer interaction. These five pillars are the main pillars within your organization. So when we look at the definition of digital transformation, and we connect that with the Cloverleaf model, with the five main pillars of the organization, then you can see that it's a well-balanced one. So all the five pillars within the Cloverleaf model are part of that definition as well. And that gives me also the motivation to share my knowledge with you, to use this Cloverleaf model during your digital transformation journey. Okay, we looked at the definition, we looked at applying structure, the Cloverleaf model, and now we can take a look at the maturity stages of a digital transformation journey. And we can start with stage one. And stage one is more or less how we started in Leiden, how a lot of companies started all over the globe. And that starting point was a lot of paperwork. Everything is done manually. And my question to you guys is this your reality right now? Please vote. Lots of paperwork. Is this at this moment your reality right now? Yes, it is. Or no, many of our processes are already digital. Curious what the result will be. Let's give you 5 seconds more. 3, 2, 1. Okay. 54. Oh, wow. Okay. Let's have a look. Okay. 50%. Yes, it is still paperwork. And 50% about no, many of our processes are already digital. This is a very interesting result. And I'm curious which companies are already there in their digital transformation journey and which company not. Maybe we can discuss that later on when this session is closed. Okay, so the first stage is a lot of paperwork. The second stage is that we digitize our papers. So not more than, okay, over here there's a paper and we digitize it so you can use it with help of a laptop, or you can email it or something like that. So that's the first stage in the digital transformation journey. The next stage is that you start with redesign the way how you organize your processes. So you will start with making use of workflows. You will apply IT systems into your processes. The way of working for us as an employee will be different. So you need some new skill sets. And the way how we restructure our processes into the organization is also part of that journey. So when we look at the Cloverleaf model, the structure of your digital transformation journey, you can see that with this stage, processes, the people part, the IT part, and the organization part are part of that journey. And the final stage in the maturity of digital transformation is that you totally redesign the concept of your service delivery. So for example, 20 years ago, I went to a travel agency to book a holiday. Nowadays, I use my mobile phone and I can book my holiday with help of my device. But there is also already a next stage, and that's the stage of, for example, Airbnb, that when I have a second home, I can place that home on the Airbnb platform, and you guys, for example, can directly contact me and book my house. So that's the next stage of the digital transformation journey, that a travel agency is not necessary anymore, but we can do business together without help of a without help of a travel agency. So that are some stages in a digital transformation journey. And yeah, then you can see that all five components of the Cloverleaf model are included in that journey. And yeah, unfortunately, we are dealing right now with COVID. And when you look at what happened the last couple of months, is that a lot of organizations started their digital transformation journey because of COVID, and they digitized their papers. So that was the first stage of the digital transformation journey, digitizing your forms. But the world is changing. The world is changing on and on. New technologies from paper-based to digital, new ways of working, new employee expectations, and so on. So then the next question arises. Is digitizing your documents enough, or is it necessary to take a next step in that digital transformation journey? So I'm curious what your opinion is about this question. Is digitizing documents enough? Yes, it is sufficient for right now. No, I think we should take the next step. What is your opinion about this question? Thank you so much for your quick responses. I really appreciate that. Let's have a look. Okay. Yes, digitizing documents is sufficient for now, about 16%. And no, I think we should take the next step, almost 84%. Again, there is no right and no wrong. Just curious what your response is. Thank you for your response. Interesting result again. In my opinion, but that's my opinion, and it's not the truth, but it's my opinion. In my opinion, we have to take the next step. It is important. Why is it important? It is important to, for example, improve employee experience. I'm the director, and I'm responsible for 130 people, and I feel but I feel the responsibility to give my employees enough time to work on their learning and development. I want to make sure that they can grow, that they learn new experiences, so that they are able to work in a sustainable way. And of course, it's important for cost savings. Doing more with the same number of people. So not to get rid of people, no. Doing more in terms of service delivery with the same number of people. Again, not to get rid of them. That's not my way of doing, that's not my leadership style, but I want to do more with the same number of people. So my responsibility is to work on that and give them trust, give them the space and responsibility to work on their own skill set. Yeah, so that's the reason why, in my opinion, it is important to start your digital journey. And here is a summary of characteristics of an organization that, in my experience, it's my experience, needs to take the next step. And have a look at these elements for 10 seconds or so. And yeah, I know for sure, because I'm giving advices at a lot of organizations at home and abroad. I know for sure that for a lot of organizations, these elements are still reality. And the customer interaction, the customer satisfaction, isn't good enough. And that is serious business in my opinion, because we are responsible for high quality service delivery to our customers. And if they aren't satisfied with us, they are complaining and on, yeah, it's our responsibility to start the journey and make sure that the service delivery is at a higher level. So that's why it is important to make sure that you know where you are right now. Look at these characteristics and be aware whether or not your customers are happy with your service delivery. Success is key. So, to be very honest, I can imagine the difficulty of starting the digital transformation journey. When I started the digital transformation journey in Leiden University, it was tough. Of course, it was tough. But it's not impossible. Not at all. We succeed. We implemented a financial shared service center. We implemented an HR shared service center. We implemented a multifunctional operations department. Finance, HR, IT, documents, all under one responsibility. I'm the director of that department. So it is tough, but yeah, it is possible. It is possible. We already did it. And a couple of years ago, I was working at UCT. And what we did was organizing a Experience the New Way of Working conference. Because in my opinion, it's important that people within the organization really understand what a digital transformation journey is. Of course, my presentation now, only 30 minutes, is interesting, but it's high level. With this Experience a New Way of Working conference, we took 2 days and we explained in detail how your new way of working will look like in future when you start the digital transformation journey. And the interesting thing was that the people at UCT liked this conference a lot, and they like that new way of working. They are very keen to step into the next phase of the digital transformation journey. So that's part of my advice. When you start your journey, of course, people are a bit afraid. Okay, what is it in for me? At a conference like this, to take the time and to explain in detail and to show it in detail helps a lot in engaging and giving people confidence that this journey is a tough one, but a very interesting journey for them as well. Not only for the organization, but for them as well. So that's my advice, to take the time and explain in detail and to show it in detail what the new way of working will look like. And let's use a metaphor. I would like to ask you, in 2019, the World Championship Rugby was in Japan. And I want to have a very honest answer, Who expected South Africa to win the world title? Yes, of course, I certainly expected that. No, that was just a part of a dream. Okay, South African people, I'm curious what the result will be. Let's have a look if I will get back some very honest answers. Here we go. Oh, wow. Yes, I certainly expected that. What a confidence. And no, that was just part of a dream. Okay, interesting. Have a look. Yes, you guys won the world title. And have a look. I was in Cape Town in November 2019. Have a look. Yes. I was with Mr. Ashley Francis. He's a part of the audience here as well. And we both, with a lot of people, South African people, watched the final. And yeah, it was fun. And congrats to you, all you guys. Because it was an excellent tournament, and yes, I was very proud of you South Africans, because you all joined the world title so very much. But was it a coincidence or just a result of a well thought out plan? And when we look behind the scenes, and I did some desktop research, I think it wasn't a coincidence, because there was very good leadership. Rassie Erasmus, the head coach And he is excellent. And what he did, he made his asset, his most important asset, the people, he made them very important. And that's how I work as well, how my way of thinking is as well. The most important asset of an organization are the people. So Rossi Erasmus made his asset, his most important asset, he made it important. His team members. And yeah, there was a plan. He was a technical genius, and he set up a plan. And he made his team part of a dream, a common goal. So the Eastern Cape Men has transformed a struggling team, because 2 years before the World Championship started, they lost a test match with 52-0 from the All Blacks. He made a struggling team. He sold his game plan to his team, and that was part of the success. And when we use that metaphor in our digital transformation journey, we can see some, yeah, let's say, similarities. Because, in my opinion, the optimal mix for a digital transformation is having a guiding vision, a plan. Where are you now? What is your as-is situation? How will your to-be situation look like? And how can we make sure that we go from A to B? So you need a plan. And just like the South African rugby team, there must be a leader who really understands how a digital transformation works. And when you combine a plan with leadership and a change strategy with help of the Cloverleaf model, 5 main pillars, when you combine that, then the basis is there for starting a good, well thought digital transformation journey. So the journey the South African rugby team made is more or less the same journey in our domain. Yes, there was a big gap, but yes, they succeed with help of a plan, with help of leadership, and with help of a strategy, the big 5 of the Cloverleaf model change strategy. So I really see some similarities, so keep in mind that their success is also for me an energizer, that the success in our digital transformation journey is also possible. And yes, we already did it in Leiden. And I'm really keen to share my knowledge with you guys to help you a bit with starting or taking the next step in your digital transformation journey. And what I already said before, the most important asset of an organization, just like the South African rugby team, it was the team who was responsible for the success. In my opinion, the most important asset in an organization is you. We employees are responsible for the success. And yes, we need a leader And yes, we need a plan. And yes, we need change strategy, the Cloverleaf model. But we people, human beings, we are responsible for the success. And that's why, for me, it was so important to organize that Experience the New Way of Working conference at UCT, because I'm keen to explain in detail. I want to engage with people that they clearly understand where are we going to, and also discuss with them what their role will be in that journey. The most important asset of an organization is you. And yes, the journey will be tough, because when you think that this will be your journey, a smooth ride from A to B, unfortunately, no. That is not the reality. It's running a complex project like this is more like this. And that's not a problem. That's not a problem. Because when you make sure that there is a guiding plan, when you make sure that there is leadership who will guide the team from A to B, when you make sure that there is a change strategy with help of the Cloverleaf model, I know for sure that you will succeed in your journey. But yeah, again, it is a tough journey, but it's more than worthwhile. And I can say that when I look at my employees in my shared service center, they are happy. Every time they do different type of things, they are responsible for running projects. It's not only doing repetitive tasks. They can work on their learning goals. They can work on the performance goals, and we can engage a lot with each other. So yeah, it is a tough journey, but it is a worthwhile one. And that brings me to the final slide, just a summary of the last 25-30 minutes. Some takeaways, steering from the intention. So the ambition, just like the South African rugby team, there was an ambition. And that ambition was, okay, we would like to win the world title. And for us, we are keen to start our journey and create a sustainable way of working. That's our ambition. Of course, it's important to clearly understand the maturity of your organization, ensure there's a change strategy. I explained that already several times, and I really advise you to use the Cloverleaf model, the five components of the organization. And again, I'm really keen to tell you much more about that Cloverleaf model, because that is part of our success in Leiden. And I've been invited a lot of times at home and abroad to explain in detail what the Cloverleaf model means. Okay, external and internal focus. So know your customers well. Think big, but start small. So, okay, think big is, okay, we want to create a sustainable way of working. That's the big goal. But how can we make sure that we start our journey? So you must start with taking small steps. Again, involve employees in the process. Employees are the most important, valuable asset of the organization. Make sure you have the right people on board. And what I mean with that is that some probably there aren't some skills in your team that you need in your journey. Okay, if that is the case, probably you must hire one extra guy or woman to make sure you can start your journey. Modern leadership, we talked about it. And now let's take a look at our head coach of the South African rugby team. And probably the most important advice, looking ahead and learning instead of looking back and paying off. Okay, thank you so much for taking time to listen to me. Thank you so much for your interaction. I really appreciate that. And again, I'm really keen to give you some more information in detail and help you a bit in starting or taking the next step in your digital transformation journey. Thank you so much for your attention.
Thank you, Rob. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your presentation and your insights into radical digital transformation.
Yeah.
Surely, I see you brought a lot of your rugby supporters into this presentation. If you're looking for the vote to be the next coach, I think you'll have mine. I think you...
Thank you.
So I think, colleagues, very important. I think the basics, I think going forward, we have to look at the future, have to make some changes, have to adopt the digital journey. Otherwise, we are going to miss the wave. With regards to Rob's presentation, it will be available on the website, and a recording of the presentation as well will be available on the website. We have a few minutes to take some questions. Any comments and points for clarification, we are ready to answer your questions. I think there may be a few in the chat box, and we'll ask Aya to go through them.
All right, Rob. I have a couple of questions for you from the audience. The first one is, what can digital transformation project members do to engage stakeholders?
Yeah. Okay. This is a key question, and thank you for that question. Part of the Clove Leaf model is the customer interaction. So when you start your journey, when you set up a project, it is key to make sure that the voice of the customer is part of that journey. So you must engage a lot with your customers. You must then, I think you must then take part of your project teams so that they can give input for your project. They can give input for your journey. So yeah, they are more or less part of the DNA of the project. So that's my answer, and that's how we organized our digital transformation in Leiden as well, to make the customers part of that journey.
All right, Rob, thank you so much for that. Another question we have is, what are four main areas of digital transformation a business should always maintain?
Sorry, can you
what are the four main areas of digital transformation a business should always maintain?
Okay. That brings me again to the Clove Leaf model. Again, when you start your digital transformation journey, it is not a finance driven journey. It's not a HR driven journey. It's not an IT driven journey. it is a new way of thinking in operations domain. So when you keep that in mind and combine that with the Clavleaf model, I think that redesigning your service delivery to your end users brings you to redesign your processes with help of IT. For example, bringing your processes to the end users via a mobile environment. So processes, IT, service delivery, customer interaction. And yeah, that means a new way of working. So you must invest a lot in change management. You must invest a lot in communication. You must invest a lot in engaging with the business. And probably that is the most important time-consumable part of your project. So that is my answer.
All right, Rob, thank you so much. We have one more question from the audience, and it is, what do you think about getting rid of ERP systems, and what should replace them?
Yeah, okay. That's part of the Clavleaf model, the IT component of the Clavleaf model. Okay, interesting thing. Where are we now? In these states, a lot of organizations having a, let's say, old-fashioned IT environment. So that is the as-is situation. The to-be situation is that we move more and more to the cloud. When we take that, when we keep that in mind, moving to the cloud, it is not necessary to make to step into a 100% cloud or environment, IT landscape. In my opinion, there is also something in between. And that means that you will go for a hybrid model. Some systems running on-premise, so within your own organization, and some processes will transform to more a cloud-based environment. So my advice is to discuss this extremely good and make sure that the top of the organization, the board, is part of this decision, because this is one of the fundamentals of your digital transformation journey. Do you stay on-prem? Will you go to a full cloud environment, or will you go for a hybrid model? So that is part of my answer. And of course, we can discuss this topic for hours and hours, but we do not have time enough for that.